Hi everybody, thank you for watching my video on physics. The topic in this video is measuring the specific heat capacity of aluminium. You will learn the basic techniques in measuring the specific heat capacity of a solid metal. We shall also discuss the precautions that may reduce the experimental errors. In the previous video, you have learned an experiment to measure the specific heat capacity of water. To measure the counterpart of solid metal, the setup is a little bit different. However, the principle is the same. Again, we shall measure three quantities: heat supply Q, mass of aluminium M, and temperature change delta T. Then we shall apply the formula C equal to Q divided by M divided by delta T to calculate the required specific heat capacity. The apparatus used are similar: a power supply, a joulemeter, an immersion heater, a thermometer, a triple beam balance, and of course an aluminium block. In order to improve the experiment, we shall also use some oil for improving the heat content. We shall also use an expanded polystyrene towel and some cotton wool for improving heat insulation. To start the experiment, place the aluminium block on the triple beam balance. Record the mass as M equal to 1.06 kg. The aluminium block is a cylinder with two holes drilled on the flat surface, one for holding the immersion heater and the other for holding the thermometer. Now, insert the immersion heater and the thermometer into the aluminium block and apply some oil to the holes. This improves the heat conduction between the metal and the apparatus. Place the metal block on the polystyrene tile. Wrap the metal block with cotton wool. Now, connect the immersion heater to the power supply through a joulemeter. Record the initial joulemeter reading E0 and the initial temperature T0. Now, let's start heating the block. Turn on the power supply. The thermometer reading should increase steadily. When the temperature has risen by about 10 degrees Celsius, turn off the power supply. We have to wait until the heat distributes uniformly over the metal block. This occurs when the temperature reaches the maximum value. We call the final joulemeter reading E1 and the highest temperature T1. The energy supply Q is E1 minus E0. That is 64,100 minus 46,400 equal to 17,700 joules. The change in temperature is delta T equal to 35 minus 20 equal to 15 degrees Celsius. We can now apply the formula C equal to Q divided by M divided by delta T to calculate the specific capacity of aluminium. The result is C equal to 17,700 divided by 1.06 divided by 15 equal to 1,113 joules per kilogram per degree Celsius. Note that the result is higher than the standard value of 900 joules per kilogram per degree Celsius. This is acceptable because there is heat loss to the surroundings, and energy is needed to raise the temperature of the apparatus, such as the heater itself and the thermometer. In summary, you have learned how to measure the specific heat capacity of aluminium using standard equipment in a laboratory. In this experiment, several points need to note. Firstly, to prevent heat loss to the surrounding, place the aluminium block on a polystyrene tile and wrap it with cotton wool. Secondly, to improve the heat content between the metal and the apparatus, oil is applied to the holes. Finally, after switching off the power supply, we have to wait until the thermometer records the highest temperature. Question for discussion. Explain why we cannot use water to replace oil. Be the first to write your answer in the comments below. You are also welcome to comment on the answer of other people. I hope this video can help you understand more about the details in measuring the specific capacity of aluminium. Thank you for watching.